My name is Lee Ritchey. This is another video in the string of videos by Altium on high-speed design. Earlier in a video, we talked about Crosstalk, and this video is to explain exactly what it is and how to manage it. And so I've drawn on here some circuits. So the green one is a line that is active, and on the two ends of it, you can see the waveforms that are leaving the transmitter here and then later on showing up the receiver. And the pink one is a victim, where we don't want noise coupled into that victim from the driven line. But if we get too close, we will see crosstalk, and what you see depends on which end you observe of the victim line, where this end is called the backward end because it's at the backward end of the signal path, or lately it's been called near in crosstalk or NEXT. And then the other end is far end crosstalk or FEXT or forward crosstalk. And you'll notice the waveforms are different. And so that's what we're going to see. And over here I have a little graph that shows how the two kinds of crosstalk vary as we extend the length at which two traces are side by side. You'll notice that forward crosstalk grows rather gradually but keeps on going. If we were to stay parallel long enough, the signal would be the same in both of these two receivers. That's the stuff that drove the phone company crazy with those cables with all the wires. If you were around when we still were using those, once in a while you might faintly hear another phone conversation on yours, and that was forward crosstalk. Well, the other, backward crosstalk, very different. You'll notice it grows much more quickly, but there comes a point where continuing to run parallel does not result in any more crosstalk. Well, RF engineers use this phenomena with a thing called a directional coupler, where we use a victim line like this and sample what's right here as a way to measure what the power level is in the driven line. Well, we don't have any phenomena like that in digital that is useful. Crosstalk is always negative in digital. So what we're going to, and what you can see here is that we get in trouble with backward crosstalk long before we get forward crosstalk. And in printed circuit boards, it's about the only thing we have to worry about. So how do we limit the amount of crosstalk? Well, one of the things that is proposed is to limit the length at which you run side by side. And this Altium tool has got a control in there that you can put in a variable. It says no longer than X number of mils. Well, so that implied in that statement is you're going to stop running side by side while you're down on this slope someplace. That's what's implied in that statement. Well, this chart over here is showing you rise time on the horizontal axis and critical length on the vertical, and I just put in one variable here. On an earlier couple of videos, I mentioned that most modern logic has 100 picosecond edges, and we need to have crosstalk rules and all other rules that allow us to succeed with that kind of rise time. Well, if you look right here at 100 picosecond edge, we hit critical length at half an inch, about that much. Well, how many boards will we route if that's as long as we can run side by side? Well, fairly close to none. So controlling backward crosstalk by restricting length of parallel run is not going to work. So what does work? Well, I'll make another slide here and show you what does work. So what I've drawn on the whiteboard right here is once we know we have to route longer than critical length, doesn't matter if we continue to route side by side longer because crosstalk does not get worse. So under those conditions, the only two variables that remain are height above the nearest plane and edge-to-edge separation. What I've drawn here is how that looks, where the black line is fairly far away from the plane, and the red one's a little closer, and the purple one's closer, and the brown's closer yet. So what we know is we can precisely control crosstalk understanding geometry. And what I'm going to do is go in my tool that analyzes these things, and I'll propose a geometry that looks like that and calculate what the crosstalk will be. And it may turn out that it's not a good number, so I'll either increase S or reduce H or maybe both. And now one of the things that, I might as well talk about this, one of the things that people want to do is put in a thing called a guard trace, which means inserting another trace in there, periodically hooking it to the thing called ground, hoping that that will cause crosstalk to go away. Well, it doesn't really. So I'll put some numbers on this right now for one case. The classic routing is, for most people, 5 mil line, 5 mil space. And 5 mil height. That's very, very common. And if you do that, you'll find that that would be, well, I'm taking this number from memory, about 8% crosstalk for this condition right here. And if you didn't like that, you would say, well, all right, I'll put a guard trace in. Well, what does it take to put a guard trace in? I have to separate these two by a 5 mil trace and a 5 mil space. And so now S is not 5 mils, it's 15 mils. And we go from 8% to way out here at about 0.8%. And sure enough, the crosstalk went down, but it wasn't the guard trace that did it. It was a mechanical separation that did it. Now, if we had more time, I would show you, having done microwave engineering, where I make bandpass filter by putting traces side by side. When you add that extra trace in there, you run the risk of increasing crosstalk, not making it less. So to kind of sum this thing up, the way we know to control crosstalk is by figuring out a height above the nearest plane and edge-to-edge separation that guarantees crosstalk never exceeds whatever our budget is, then we don't have to worry about how long we route side by side. That's the way the high-speed computer industry has been doing this for as long as I've been in the game. So when someone talks about restricting length of parallel run or guard traces, neither one of those are the right answer. In fact, guard traces makes the layout more difficult and runs the risk of causing a problem. So I hope that helps clear up crosstalk a little bit more than what we had in the earlier videos. And this is, there's no real magic to this. That analysis right there is a 5-minute chore with a tool like hyperlinks. And if you follow this method, you never get in trouble from crosstalk. One of the things that designers will say, well, God, if I have to separate the traces by that much, I'll never fit all the traces on the routing layer. Well, that's probably true. That may force you to have more layers. But what you're suggesting, if you don't want to do that, is that by some method you have discovered a way to suspend the laws of physics every now and then. And of course, you know, my favorite Einstein quote is this. He would say this to his graduate students who wanted to take shortcuts. Say, everything should be as simple as possible and no simpler. And this is as simple as possible for crosstalk. Hope that helped.